Hey spoon crafters and bush carvers out there, this is Max from Woodsman's Finest. Today this is another pro tip in my spoon carving 101 series. Sorry for the occasional noise, this is urban Japan, as you probably know by now. I want to come at you today with a very simple tip, something very essential for spoon carving that maybe hasn't really made it into everybody's attention yet, which is the Bodgers Bib. A lot of people ask me what I'm carrying around my neck when I'm carving. It looks odd, and I just want to give you a little bit of an introduction into Bodgers Bibs. Basically, the Bodgers Bib has two functions, or two main purposes. One of them is to protect you from whatever tool that you're using, and the other one is to protect you from whatever you're working on. What I mean by the tool that you're using is that there's Bodgers Bibs for all kind of different purposes, and I just want to first as well say about the material that Bodgers Bibs come usually in materials like leather or wood, and I'm sure there's other materials out there you can make it from, but the main characteristic of a Bodgers Bib is that it's not too hard, and I'm going to explain quickly why, and it's not too soft. Now if you're using a regular Sloyd knife like my beloved and much used Mora 105. Man, I'm always coming back to this knife. I have a lot of other knives and I like them all, but the one that I'm using most is just really my Mora 105. In any case, so if you're using your Sloyd knife, or you're using, for example, a draw knife on a spoon mule or a shave horse, then there's obviously very, very sharp knives coming towards you. Now if you're using proper technique, as you can find in my proper knife technique videos, there's not a lot of risk there that you cut yourself with the knife, especially if you keep your elbows tight, as I'm always talking about, and using proper form and pointing the tip away from you. However, it is important to protect your chest and your clothing. So in this case, the purpose is obviously to protect yourself from the blade. Especially, it has happened to me in the past, sitting on the shave horse and actually slipping with the draw knife and too much force coming towards me, and it has come awful close. In the end, proper technique and keeping my elbows tight really saved me from touching at least, or destroying some of my shirts or something like that. It's, you know, with a draw knife, it's still difficult to cut or do any real damage, but it is, you know, there is some type of risk. So, now a lot of Bodgers Bibs that I have seen for spoon mules and shave horses are from wood, and usually they have some kind of indentation in there or some kind of structure to hold the workpiece firmly on that, because wood obviously is a lot more slippery. Now, most of the Bodgers Bibs that I see are from leather. And that goes into the second part, or the second purpose of this Bodgers Bib, and that is to protect you from the workpiece. If I'm working on spoons all day long with rather pointy backs, or like with an unfinished tail or whatever, there is a lot of sharp corners on here, sometimes even points, and I'm bracing that against my sternum all day long. And what I saw happening, and the problem I had very, very initially when I started probably 7-8 years ago, was just literally my clothes being shredded, and so was the skin on my sternum. It's just very, very uncomfortable to constantly brace your workpiece against your sternum without protection. And in another pro tip, I'm gonna go into why the bracing of the workpiece is extremely useful in carving, spoon carving, and a lot of other crafts, and different techniques that I'm using for that. So these are the two purposes. The main materials, as I said before, are leather and wood. So now, why is that, and how can that be done? You can easily make your own Bodgers Bibs from these two materials, but there is a couple things you have to look for. First of all, if the material that you're using for a Bodgers Bib is very hard, there's gonna be some structure on it to hold it, because otherwise, if you're bracing the workpiece against that, it keeps slipping and sliding off to one side. So a lot of Bodgers Bibs that I've seen from wood are very useful, especially using a draw knife or bracing a bigger workpiece like a paddle or a broomstick, whatever you're working on, against a surface like a corner or something, and then bracing it against your Bodgers Bib and basically being the vice yourself. That's why I'm talking a lot about body vices, but there is a different video about that specific technique. But in any case, so you need something on there, like a little divot or some kind of hole, some structure that holds it from slipping sideways. And actually that is a very dangerous thing, because you're often leaning a lot of force into your workpiece using your body, and if it slips, then that can go wrong, especially if your knife comes back and slipping off, your fingers come into the path of the knife. That is something way more dangerous than actually cutting yourself. So there's gonna be some structure or something on there to hold it. With leather, it's a little bit the same problem. I've seen a lot of Bodgers bibs that were done from vegetant leather, and they're great. The problem is just the very hard vegetant leather is extremely slippery as well, very, very similar to wooden surface. So because of that, me personally, I have gone to making my Bodgers bibs from very thick elk neck. I get that in Europe, we use these kind of leathers for our leather pants. I'm Austrian Bavarian, so in my area, elk neck or elk leather is tanned in a certain type, like in a certain way, that the neck is actually left nearly a centimeter thick. And what I found is that this is really easily adapting to somebody's chest, especially if you're a craftswoman, then it's probably easier for you to carve with that comfortably than having something from wood or a leather piece that is too hard and doesn't really form to your chest shape. Another really big advantage of this type of material is that it's kind of pliable in a way that it's thick enough to protect my sternum, but it's thin, it's pliable enough to kind of hold on to the spoon. As you can see, I use my spoon to push the Bodgers bib around rather than it's just slipping off. So there's all kind of shapes you can cut out for yourself. In this case, this is just a piece of elk neck. I left it a little bit bigger. I have smaller ones as well. I sold them in the past as well. But if you want to source your own material, find something that you can use. Maybe 3 or 4 leather layers of felt that are glued together with 2 holes in it in some kind of trapezius shape would work really well. And what you do then is, like, you make 2 holes and you apply 2 separate strings and you tie either end of them with a half hitch around the other side. Is the string from the other side that's tied on here, it's just kind of coming over around my neck, and then I just take that piece and just do a half hitch. It's tight enough, there's nothing pulling on this Bodgers bib. It's tight enough, and what it does is basically it's giving me a slide adjustment. So now if I want to have my Bodgers bib lower, I just gonna slide this up a little bit, and automatically the other side slides as well, and it's coming lower down. If I want to put it higher up, I pull this side, I pull that side, the friction holds it in place and it's higher up. So this is a very, very easy way to adjust your Bodgers bib's height. Okay, so I really hope that this pro tip helped you today. I'm not gonna give you the whole YouTube rundown, because I think by now you really know how to support the channel if you wish so and if you like this. 2 things I wanna point out is, first of all, so what I would like to know from you folks in the comment section today is, for my upcoming Craft podcast that I started already recording the first episodes and I have a lot of guests lined up, would you mind having this podcast hosted here on YouTube? And this way you can just have this YouTube video basically running while you are working on something, while you're driving or so, and you don't have to look. But since I have already a channel established here on YouTube, it would be a lot easier to reach all my other viewers with the Craft podcast just being hosted here. I will additionally definitely host it as well somewhere else, but I'm extremely busy actually doing my work, making these videos, keeping my Instagram channel alive, and that's all great. The problem is just I don't know if I have time to promote another platform. I'm really stoked about the upcoming podcast though, so please let me know in the comment section what you think about that, and I hope this was helpful for you today. Sorry for the noise, folks. I'm trying to bring this at you like straight and direct from this location here in urban Japan. And in order for me to get a good place to film, this is pretty much the only place where I can do this. And there is a little bit of noise happening here all the time. So thank you, folks, for watching today. Thanks for the support. I hope you're doing good wherever you are. And I'm gonna see you next time. Cheers.